On June 17, 2017, a large landslide occurred at a steep cliffside in remote western Greenland. As 39 million cubic meters of rock slid into the ocean a mile to the east, it displaced the water, generating a towering wave. A tsunami had been generated with an initial wave height of 90 meters or 295 feet. A little more than a minute later, this towering wave crashed against the opposite side of the fjord 6 kilometers away, attaining a height of 50 meters or 164 feet. Moving outwards from its source, a series of several waves moved towards the town of Nuugaatsiaq. Upon hitting the town, the tsunami ran up the coastline to areas 9 meters or 30 feet above sea level. After the water had receded, the destruction was significant. 48% of all structures in the town had been destroyed, and there was significant coastal erosion. Because of all the damage that occurred, both Nuugaatsiaq and Ilorosuit were mostly abandoned. I would not recommend living in either of these cities for a long time simply because of a looming hazard. Upon further investigation, it was revealed that three additional sections of the same mountainside adjacent to a collapse that year are also highly structurally unstable and are prone to collapsing with little or no warning. One of these zones encompasses a much larger area totaling 3.65 square kilometers of land, the top layer of which could collapse into the ocean, generating a tsunami many times larger than witnessed in 2017. If all of this collapsed, the resulting tsunami would also most likely reach the towns and villages shown on screen to a certain extent. However, the list of population centers is not all-inclusive, and areas which are not labeled and cities further away could also be affected. So, why did the tsunami occur? Since 1850, at least 7 such large-scale tsunamis have been created by partial edifice collapse of a weakened mountainside or cliff in colder parts of the world. For example, one tsunami on July 9th of 1958 in Alaska's Latoya Bay produced the tallest tsunami ever recorded, with a maximum run-up height of 524 meters or 1,720 feet. However, while this tsunami was in part caused by a large magnitude earthquake, the cause of the Greenland tsunami is believed to be a bit different. In cold regions around the world, the ground to a certain depth is often permanently frozen in what is known as permafrost. The permafrost is quite hard and structurally sound, while a thin layer known as the active layer often overlies it, which is not always frozen. Due to rising temperatures in western Greenland, the layers of permafrost on the ground have become thinner and thinner. This has created a large active layer which is more prone to erosion. With a reduced thickness of permafrost holding steep slopes together, which in this case is generally cited as greater than 50 degrees, a large landslide became near inevitable. The first smaller landslide on the same steep slope, which would later produce a larger collapse, occurred in 2009. Then, 7 years later, a larger slide occurred, causing 3.25 million cubic meters of rock to collapse. And, only a year after the prior collapse, the large tsunami-generating landslide occurred. If possible, I would also avoid sending any ships adjacent to the potential landslide hazard. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member Scott Ross for supporting this channel.